Dear learners, in today's video tutorial, we'll show how to conduct panel data regression. Particularly, we'll discuss how to perform fixed effect and random effect model regression using panel data. So, panel data is derived from a number of sample units that are collected over several time periods for same sample unit. In other words, observations of different sample units in which a same sample is with different time periods. So let's take the example of panel data. The first table, table 1, that is called balanced panel data. So panel data could be balanced or unbalanced. You can see here that sample unit, we have different sample unit like A, B, C. It could be for a particular individual or person or similar type of entity. So we have different sample. Now for the same sample unit, we have different time period. So for sample unit A, we take the income and expenditure data for the year 2015-16-17. Similarly, for our sample unit B, we have take this data for the year 2015-17. For sample unit C, we have take this data for the from 2015-2017. So you see, we have different sample units and these different time periods, and there is no missing time period. So this is the panel data. As there is no missing observation here, so we called it balanced panel data. The difference between table 2 and table 1 is, you can see here, like, you see for the sample unit A, that's fine for here because we got all the year data 2015-17, but from for sample B, we have a missed year, that is, you can see here, there is no data for the year 2016. Similarly, for sample unit C, we have a missing data for year 2017. So if you have missing observation here, we call it unbalanced panel data. So remember, when you need to conduct this panel data regression, your data should be organized like this way in a strata. Now there are two techniques of using panel data. One is called fixed effect, another one is called random effect. So what are the difference between these two? Panel data allows you to control for the effect of time invariant variables, which we called unobserved characteristics. That means which you cannot observe or measure. For example, cultural differences. So this could be unobserved characteristics which you cannot actually measure. And this may differ across entities. So this may differ across individuals, this may differ across countries, regions, whatever. This actually called as this differs, so we called it unobserved heterogeneity. And this unobserved heterogeneity can be addressed by using fixed effect and random effect model. So these are called actually static panel data regression technique. In both fixed effect and random effect model, we consider that this unobserved heterogeneity, this actually affects your outcome variable. However, the basic difference between fixed effect and random effect model is that in fixed effect model, we assume that apart from affecting your outcome variable Y, unobserved heterogeneity is correlated with or affects the predictor as well. However, random effect model assumes that unobserved heterogeneity only affects Y and is not correlated with or affects the predictor. It will be like this one. Sorry. Okay, so to identify the appropriateness, whether you need to use fixed effect or random effect model, we need to perform Hausman test in Stata. So we will show you how to do this in Stata in our next part.